Hello guys, kamusta po? Welcome mga kapatid rito sa channel ko, ano? Kamusta po ang lahat? Naway okay po ang sitwasyon natin ngayon. Saan man tayo ngayon, nasa Pilipinas man or nasa ibang bansa, patuloy po tayong mag-iingat dahil may virus pa rin po at delikado at nakamamamatay, no? Alright, sa ngayon po ay meron na naman po tayong isang napakagandang topic na for sure ay kapupulutan po natin ng magandang aral, ano? So, some of the people around the world ay may problema talaga when it comes to trust issue, ano? Mga magkakaibigan, maraming nasisira actually dahil po sa tiwala na, ano, sa trust issue, ano? So, some of the reasons bakit dapat nating iwasan ng isang tao kapag ka may mga ugali po sila ng kakaiba, no? Dahil for sure ay wala pong magandang patutunguhan, no? Yung mga yan. So, in short, ngayon po, I will be discussing, ano, 7 types of people whom you should never trust, ano? So, kagaya ng sabi ko kanina, maraming pagkakaibigan talagang nasira dahil sa trust issue, ano? Pero, bibigyan ko po kayo ng kaunting mga detalye or kaunting mga reasons, ano? Or kaunting mga klase ng mga tao kung yung mga dapat po nating iwasan, ano? So, some of the reasons bakit nasisira ang mga tao, unang-una na riyan, base po sa realidad ng mundo, utang. Kapag ang ating kaibigan ay nangungutang, alam niyo po yun, yung nangungutang sa'yo, awang-awa ka, tinulungan mo. Pagdating ng panahon, hindi na nagpapakita sa'yo, pag sinisingil mo, galit pa sa iyo. So, marami po ba rito nakaka-experience ng ganyan? For sure, marami po, ano, isa na po tayo dyan, di ba? So, yun po, iwasan po natin yung mga tao na, mga kaibigan rather, na alam nyo yun, yung nagtitake advantage po sa ating kabaitan, ano? Kasi hindi po sila deserving na maging kaibigan po natin. Sa mga mag-boyfriend, girlfriend naman, di ba? Yung iba naman dyan, yung mga magkakaibigan, dahil lang po sa isang lalaki or sa isang babae, nagkakasira-sira ang pagkakaibigan. So, kung if you really good friend, kung talagang tunay ka pong kaibigan, isaalang-alang niyo po ang mga bagay-bagay na ganito, di ba? So, and then, kung sa business naman po, sa business aspect naman po, what if yung isang tao dyan nagbi-business na, alam mo yun, yung mga taong inggitero, business na dito, tapos ikaw naman, nagpo-put up ka rin ng business mo, para lang to compete sa iyong kaibigan dahil ayaw mong malamangan. May mga tao po talagang mga ganyan, ano? Yan po ang realidad dito sa mundong ibabaw, ano? So may mga taong na gusto nila sila lang yung nagtatanggupay, gusto nila yung kanilang kapwa-tao ay mahirap pa din, ano? And of course, yung iba naman pagdating sa trabaho, alam mo 'yon, yung sip-sip, yung alam mo 'yon, yung parang linta kung makaano sa amo, kala mo naman ano? Alam mo naman kasosyo, di ba? So kapatid, tayo po ay mga tao, dapat magintindihan po tayo, ano? Mahalin po natin ang isa't isa, ano? So sa video pong ito, naway may matutunan naman tayong lahat, ano? Pwede rin natin itong apply sa ating mga buhay. Nang sa ganun ay maagapan natin ang mga bagay-bagay or mga sitwasyong di ka nais-nais. So mga kapatid, kung bago rito sa channel ko, naway huwag mong kalimutang mag-like, mag-comment, mag-subscribe at of course, i-click ang notification button. Anong sa ganun ay maging updated ka, kapatid, kapag may mga bago po tayong videos, ano. So ito po, ang video pong ito ay para sa akin po ay napakalaking factor o napakalaking impact po ito para sa ating lahat dahil alam ko po, some of us ay talagang nakaka-experience po ng ganito para maiwasan po natin ang mga bagay na di ka nais-nais. Dapat maging mabait lang po tayo sa ating kapwa. Yun, maging magpakatotoo tayo. Iwasan na po natin yung ano, pagiging, alam niyo yun, yung pagiging plastic, di ba? Kasi tao po tayo, isipin po natin dito po sa mundong ibabaw, tayo po ay temporary lamang. Kahit ikaw man ay mayaman o ikaw man na mahirap, isa lang po ang ating patutunguhan. Wala pong permanente sa mundong ito. Tayo pong lahat ay maglaho. Tayo pong lahat ay ililibing. Diba? Tayo pong lahat ay mamamatay. Kaya panatilin po nawa natin sa ating mga sarili ang una-una dapat pagiging maka-Diyos, makatao, and makabayan of course. So, mahalin natin ang isa't isa dahil hindi po natin hawak ang buhay natin. Kagaya ngayon, may pandemya. Tapos ang sama-sama ng ugali mo sa kapwa mo, di ba? Malay mo, someday sama o madapuan ka ng virus, baka yun pa yung mitsa na mawala ka dito sa mundong ito. Kaya kapatid, magpakabait po tayo. No? So, yun lamang po. Itong video pong ito, panoorin nyo po. Alam ko po, kapupulutan nyo po ito ng aral. Ingat po ang lahat. To God be the glory. God bless us all. Po.
You may have heard the admonition to trust no one, but that is not practical for daily living. If you want to be trusted, you must be able to give out trust. And for you to build long-lasting relationships, you must trust and be trusted. However, there is a need to be careful about how and who you trust. On who to trust, heed to this anonymous quote. Never trust a person that lets you down more than two times. Once was a warning, twice was a lesson, and anything more than that is simply taking advantage. And so, in this video, I will share with you 7 types of people you should never trust. 1. Fickle-minded people. Did you ever play on a seesaw? Well, let me explain how it works. When you sit on a seesaw with someone on the opposite side, each of you takes turns pushing off the ground. When you go up into the air, the other person touches the ground, and when that person goes up, you go down. So that you know, the seesaw is also called this-that. A fickle-minded person is like a seesaw. A this-that person without a balance point. These types of individuals are always indecisive and give in to any suggestion, so you are not even sure if they will support you or not. Today, they will say yes to you, but the next day, they will change their minds and say no. You can't expect anything from them because they may disappear even when they have made commitments to you. 2. People who tell you other people's secrets. Do you have that friend who is always telling you about other people's private matters? If yes, then your secrets are probably being shared too. And just the way they tell you not to pass the information to anyone else, that is how they tell someone else not to give your information to others. Regardless of the person that they speak with, they hold no loyalty to close friends or anyone else that they come in contact with. They don't have regard for other people's confidentiality, as long as they can get something as small as the attention of others from spilling. When someone keeps sharing other people's secrets with you, it is a pointer that they will tell other people your secrets as well. Hence, you must minimize your chit-chat with such people and be careful of things you do around them. 3. People who are too sweet to you. Of course, certain people are naturally pleasing to those around them. However, many people who act nice are not lovely. They want something from you. One significant difference between the real charming individuals and those who want something from you is that real charmers open up to you about themselves and imperfections and also their whereabouts. In contrast, the fake ones act like they are flawless without opening up a bit about themselves. Also, when a formerly mean person suddenly starts acting cute, you should be careful. And when someone is unfriendly to others yet shows a special kind of liking to you, you are also allowed to be suspicious. 4. People with competitive traits. Being around a competitor can be very annoying because all they care about is getting there before anyone else. These people can go to unnecessary lengths just to prove themselves. It's unwise to tell their physical or mental weaknesses to someone who shows signs of competitive behavior because they do not mind using the information you have entrusted with them as a weapon against you, just so they can win. If a competitive individual is your friend, the method of sabotaging your winnings is quite different. They will not come straight up and say, "Hey, I don't want you to win. Hand me that prize." Instead, they will use sneaky tactics such as breaking, shocking, and perhaps false news to you just when you want to carry a task that is critical to your winning. For instance, they may whisper into your ears that your partner is cheating on you just before a major presentation. Although there are chances that having a competitor as a friend can make you step up your game, the competitive approach can breed grievances and cause a rift. 5. People with narcissistic traits. These set of people always think that the world revolves around them. According to psychologist DJ here, he said, and I quote, "A narcissistic cannot trust himself with his addictions or issues going on in his head. He does not even trust anyone and never sees anyone equal to him. Hence, he is not a trustworthy person." Narcissists are fair-weather individuals who will take advantage of you to satisfy their desires, but they are never there to offer assistance when you are in need. Even if they help you, the whole world will hear about it. For narcissists, nothing is more important to them than their ego and unhealthy self-esteem, not even your trust. 6. People who lack empathy. Just like competitors, people who lack empathy do not care about you. Their apathy will never let them put themselves in other people's shoes. Instead, they avoid any scenario that might cause them to be thoughtful and focus on how to victimize others. Moreover, those who lack empathy do not trust you. Forget the charade they put up. Since they do not attempt to understand what you think and how you feel, they don't feel safe with you. Hence, it would help if you were careful around them. 7. The social climber. These people are always desperate for public attention. They are the ones who will borrow other people's accessories to look good in the face of outsiders. Since their main goal is always to look blameless, they are usually chameleons that take on any shape or size to impress others around them. These individuals are deceitful. In most cases, they are friends with you only because of what you have. They will try to use your accomplishments and connections for their selfish benefits. If you introduce these set of people into your circle, they will use any means, even tarnishing your image, to get closer to your other friends who they perceive to be more influential or accomplished than you. When you observe a person who previously did not regard you suddenly being so persistent about being a friend after a significant success, be sure to take cover. Getting into a friendship with a social climber is like carrying a bomb in your backpack without your knowledge. Some people bring brightness to our lives while others darken our path, making it difficult for us to journey through life. In the same way, some people would do unimaginable things to help us and others wouldn't try, even if our lives depended on it. Be sensitive enough to know those who ease your journey so that you can stick to them, as well as those who make things hard for you so that you can tread carefully.